ask the board for permission to forward a special exception application received from with respect to the Wasatch Campground to the North Central Florida Regional Planning Council for their review and analysis. They provided a detailed review and analysis, which is contained in your packet. It identified a number of deficiencies in the application that was submitted, and that, along with the cover letter, was forwarded to the applicant, requesting that they correct those deficiencies and resubmit their application or amend their application. We received a letter, as well as some phone calls, but ultimately a letter from the applicant dated August 10th, 2018, is also provided in your materials, where the applicant essentially indicates that they cannot meet those requirements in order to come into compliance or satisfactorily comply with the Planning Council's interpretation of what's necessary to obtain a special exception to operate an RV park in Ag 2 zone. And so at this point, we're requesting direction from the board on how to proceed. Our recommendation is that the board interpret that letter from the applicants as an indication that they cannot bring their property into compliance and therefore withdraw their application for a special exception. And two, that being the case, direct staff to refer the property and the deficiencies to the sheriff's office for further code enforcement proceedings.
This has been fairly controversial over the last several months. There's some folks that put a lot of time and effort into helping these people out. And one of the concerns is putting people out on the street. I don't think that should be this board's intent. However, I do have great concerns of sexual predators living in this area and kids getting on off the school bus coming in and out. That close proximity to the sexual predator. I'm not sure what the solution to this issue is, but I don't want the county to set a precedent by not enforcing code violations with these folks and then down the road trying to enforce the code violations on somebody else. I'd kind of like to hear some thoughts from them. I agree, Mr. Jones.
It's a safety concern, it's a welfare concern. It certainly does need to be, and I know it has been addressed, but and I agree with not putting people out on the street, but
having the violations that have already been brought up, I have concerns about that.
And if it's the sheriff overlooking code enforcement on that, moving forward in that way, determining whether or not there are violations committed, and if that's the direction.
I would like also to encourage as much as possible that when we do this, that we're not putting kids and parents out on the street or having to work. There's try to work, and I know we haven't found it, the staff has went to great effort to try to do this. I know we've got a lot of people in the community that have spent a lot of time helping us to do for them, and that's what it should be. But there are certain requirements that I think we do need to go by. And my concern is with the kids, I'll be honest with you. The adults, they make their decision, make their choices, they have to go with it. My concern is with the children.
And I agree 100% with that, because my concern is for the children. Like you said, the adults, they can get out and work if they want to. And they made their own bed, let them lie in it. But those children, I'm very, very concerned for those children, especially if one of those sexual predators messed with one of those children. I couldn't handle it. And but I don't want to put them on the street. I've also thought about this, just like y'all have. But at the same time, if we keep going in the direction we're going, we're violating our own codes, and also we're still putting those children in harm's way. And when something happens, then we'll say, oh, we should have done something sooner. So I don't want to do that. I feel like by us making a move, then we're going to force the parents of those children to get them into a better environment. And if we can help them any way we can to get those children into a better environment so that they have a chance growing up, I'm all for it. But we do, I mean, we got a recommendation from the planning council, recommendation from our own fire department. I mean, we need to do it. Otherwise, how can we enforce any codes? So I agree. And Mr. Stevens and Ms. Smith, I know y'all have worked hard with them. I know y'all have. And it breaks my heart to have to come down to this, but we've got to look out for those children. I mean, I just, it's
I feel like this is what we have to do.
Yes, ma'am.
That's it.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The children are living. Yes, ma'am.
So we didn't need a motion, but we just need to.
Yes, sir. We would like a motion to approve the action that we've outlined. Interpreting the August 10, 2018 letter from the applicants as an indication that they do not intend to bring their property into compliance and that they withdraw their application for a special exception, and to directing staff to refer the property to the sheriff's office for code enforcement proceedings.
That's understood. I'll make that motion.
We have a motion. A second. All in favor of the motion, by the time.
Aye.
Motion taken.
And the last item I have deals with the property donated to the county by Santa Fe College for the development of the new DeResta substation. That property currently has an RSF MH1 residential single family mobile home 1 zoning designation, which allows for the development of public facilities by special exception. So we're seeking permission from the board to submit an application on the board's behalf for a special exception for that property.
I'll make a motion to approve the special exception.
Second.
And I have a motion to clarify, you're not approving the special exception. You'll have to do that sitting there at the planning and zoning board. This is to submit the application.
Yes.
So you just want us to.
Our request is for our motion to approve submitting an application for a special exception.
Okay. I'll make the motion that we approve to submit.
And that's why I'm sorry, the special exception. Thank you.
Second.
Motion and second. All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion taken.
That's all I have. Thank you.
Sheriff's report.
In Sheriff Smith's stead today, he's under the weather this morning and couldn't be here, so sends his apologies. Chairman, board, I'm going to stand before you here and just give you a very, very brief report on our flood abatement program and how things are progressing. I'm happy to report that with all the rain that we've gotten over the last few days, the movement of that water through the areas that we've already cleaned far exceeds our expectations of what it was going to be. And so we've heard from some residents this weekend and listened to some people. We've been out there quite often and looked at it ourselves, and it's doing a lot better than what we expected it was going to do. So for that, that's a happy and a good report that I wanted to give you. I stand before you this morning, though, as part of this project, I have to sign proclamations of a local state of emergency every 7 days to extend this, and I have done so on August the 22nd, signed a proclamation declaring a local state of emergency for the period of August 22nd to August 28th for the purpose of providing access to certain areas of private property and certain areas within waterways necessary to complete the Sampson River Alligator Creek tree removal and flood abatement project. With that, I'm asking now this morning that you the resolution, or that you adopt the resolution, from my proclamation.
Mr. Chairman, can, before you get the motion, can we read the title by, the resolution by title into the record? The first one is a resolution of the Board of County Commissioners of Bradford County, Florida, confirming a proclamation of a local state of emergency in Bradford County, Florida, providing effective date.
Also approved.
Second.
Motion and a second, all in favor of the motion by staff?
Aye.
Thank you, sir. I have one more.
Right.
I also signed a proclamation for the dates of August 29th to September 4th for the purpose of providing access to certain areas of private property and certain areas within waterways necessary to complete the Sampson River removal flood abatement project. I'm asking for you to adopt a resolution for that proclamation also. If you'd like to go ahead and read that. A resolution of the Board of County Commissioners of Bradford County, Florida, confirming a proclamation of a local state of emergency in Bradford County, Florida, and providing an effective date.
Have a motion.
Second.
The second. All in favor of the motion?
Aye.
Motion stands.
Thank you, sir.
Clerk's report.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to remind the board that of our public hearings on our budget. The first one is September the 13th. That's on a Thursday night. And it's at 5:30 p.m. here in the boardroom. And the final hearing will be on Monday, September the 24th at 5:30. These dates are based on the